Welcome to another vlog with the Yes to Life show. We're right now sitting here working again, and we take you with us again through another day of ours. How did the day start today?
Yeah, the day started really nice. It's actually a Sunday right now, so woke up at 5 like we always do. After 2 hours of working, we decided to go up the mountain because we're right next to this beautiful wine mountain, overlooking the entire valley. It's super beautiful and the weather was perfect, so we decided to bring the drone with us. Yeah. And we did get some nice shots with the pocket, but everything was perfect. So we had amazing shots. I saw them on my phone. We had some amazing shots. The weather was perfect. We had the right sun rising moment. Apparently there's this thing when you turn off the drone before you shut off the recording, then the file is corrupt. So then for the next 2 hours I spent the next 2 hours trying to recover the file, trying various online methods. And then there was only one way to recover it, and then the file was looking like, very crappy.
It looks so crappy, like the worst quality you can imagine. So we cannot show you that file.
I know.
So we want to go up later again, get the drone once more in the air, but the weather now is different, it's more cloudy. We're not sure if we can get the same look. Yeah, we probably won't get the same look, but it still looks cool if everything works. After that, we got back here and we were not really happy with how the footage turned out, and I was editing videos and it took longer than expected. Somehow it always takes longer than you think. We published the trailer of the new course that's coming out next week from the new Vietnamese course, and you can see it right now. So this is just a preview of what the whole course experience looks like, what it was like to be in Vietnam, because their food plays a really big role, and we want to get the most authentic experience. That's why we partnered with Rose Kitchen, which is the top-rated cooking school in Hanoi, so we can together create an authentic vegan cooking course. It will be live on Wednesday this week, and then Lucas has been working on the next course that's already up in the next 2 weeks. And I think I can tell you a little bit about that.
Yeah, I've been working on the Sayuri course, which we filmed in Bali, and it was super nice. My brother didn't get to film the course, unfortunately, because that was back when he had an accident. He got hit by a scooter, for all of the people who haven't seen the vlogs from back then. And the food was amazing. I just got done with day one today, and then tomorrow I'm going to do day two, so there's a lot of desserts coming up. Day one was more like the intro to fermentation, then also raw bread, raw cheese. It's pretty much an introduction to raw food.
And as you can see, we're not in Cologne anymore. We got this week to Trier because the apartment here has a little bit more space. It's the apartment of our dad. And yeah, it's beautifully located. You can see outside and it's quiet. And you can hear the birds outside. So it really is this nature feeling, almost as if you're like sitting in a forest. That's pretty cool.
Supposedly the oldest city in Germany, but there's always this fight between this city and Nuremberg.
I think it's pretty clear that this is the oldest city.
Is the oldest city.
So next time we'll show you also some of the buildings that are around, because they've, pretty much as Lucas said, old Roman, I don't even call it, amphitheater for instance, then like old Roman baths, old churches, all this kind of stuff, which looks pretty cool.
So it's 2 p.m. right now, we're both pretty hungry, so we're gonna start making some lunches.
So it's lunch. lunchtime right now. And as always, what we do most of the time is just looking at what we have and then throwing it together. So now it's Sunday and the fridge is almost empty. We still have sprouts left because we do our own sprouts, as we said a couple of times. So I'm going to wash them. And then we're going to add in, we have some tomatoes here, radish I think it's called. Then we have celery, smoked tofu. And then we're probably going to make some very simple dressing based on mustard, some chili, some garlic, vinegar. Super easy. Let's do it. All right, so I washed the sprouts. Gonna add them in my salad bowl right there. And I really, I don't know, I think we eat sprouts almost every day. They are never really boring. You can make really tasty salads with it, especially when you just start to add in other vegetables. So for instance, these tomatoes, I washed them quickly and then I cut them. Not too small. So these radishes, I think they're called radishes. If they aren't, let me know in the comments what's the actual name. You know, you just wash them and then have a small green end, get rid of the green end, and then you cut them into thin slices. Now I cut some smoked tofu. If you don't have smoked tofu, you can use regular tofu or just use a can of beans, black beans, chickpeas, whatever you have at hand, you know. Now for the dressing, what I like to do is I cut some spring onions, I chop garlic and chilies, add them to a bowl, I fill it up with around 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar, some soy sauce that adds some of the saltiness, and then some mustard, a little bit of olive oil, and that's pretty delicious. Leave it to soak there because then the whole sauce can absorb the flavor of the garlic and the chili a little bit, and then you just pour it over the salad. And there you go, this is a super delicious salad dressing, and you can adjust it to your liking. If you don't like spicy, add less chili. If you like it more salty, add more soy sauce and so on, right? You can even add a little bit of sugar to give it more of a sweet flavor. And now I pour it over the salad. Mix everything, and that's pretty much it.
So it's 7 p.m. right now, and we just got back from our second flight with the drone today because we really wanted to get a few nice looking shots after the disaster of this morning.
And as you can see by our smiles, this time it actually worked. Still not perfect, there's something with the...
Something with the frame rate.
But the footage looks pretty cool, and we're quite lucky because the whole day got kind of cloudy and not so nice, but the last hour the sun came out again, and I don't know, it just looks beautiful flying over the vineyards and then having the blue sky with the clouds and everything. It was a good time to go out.
And then we also got the time lapse from the Osmo Pocket. The camera is just amazing. It's so small.
You're going to see a lot of time lapse in the coming months because this function is so amazing. There's a couple of cool ideas that we have about motion lapse from buildings, if that means something to you. But you will see it when it gets to that point.
And then we're also thinking next week, Sunday, to maybe do like a bike drone trip. So we just put the drone on our backpack, and then we also put the Osmo in front of the bike, and then we just bicycle around the area looking for nice shots. And yeah, if you like that idea, let us know in the comments below. And besides that, today was a rest day, so there's no training footage from today. Tomorrow is upper body again, but yeah, today was pretty much just working.
Just in general, what kind of content would you like to see more? Would you like to see more drone footage or city footage or... I don't know, us talking more about what we eat, or we're going to the gym and working out and how that's going. Just let us know in the comments whatever you want to see. Apart from that, next week I'll be meeting my girlfriend. So I'll leave Trier, Lucas will stay here. And then we see each other again next weekend and then do the rest of the filming. Yeah. So without further ado, anything else, any last words?
Anything that's... Well, we're pretty much done now for work. It's like 7:20, I think, today. It's like 7:20 or 7:30, I think. So we're gonna have some dinner and then had to sleep pretty soon as well. And now it's actually time to put on the blue light glasses.
Oh yeah.
Like after 7 p.m. it's always time for the blue light blocking glasses, so we don't so we can sleep better.
You should actually really get some. They, at least I think they really work. I got now the yellow ones, you know, the ones Lucas has, they're kind of not yellow, so they look normal, but the ones that are yellow, you actually look kind of weird, I gotta say, but it doesn't matter. So the other day we were walking out with them, and people looked at us like, what's wrong with these guys, what kind of glasses are they wearing?
Yeah, because it also reflects blue light back, so when people look at you, it's not like regular glass, but they see all of the blue light from their devices and stuff. So it does look a little bit weird.
But if you're cool with really looking helps. Weird, that's no problem.
I bet I'd rather sleep better than, or like sleep well
than not look weird.
At places.
Okay, have a good day and see you next vlog. Thanks for watching as always.